What a time it was, it was. A time of innocence, a time of confidences. Long ago it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories, they're all that's left you.
Okay, this is a very proud day for all Republicans, but especially for Monaghan Republicans. It's great to be able to welcome people who have travelled in their busloads from all of Ireland's 32 counties, and indeed many people who travel from abroad to attend this National Hunger Strike commemoration. This is, you know, very poignant, I know, for many Republicans, especially those who from this constituency of Cavan Monaghan, who were around 32 years ago and who were active in securing the election of Kieran Doherty, hunger striker, a Belfast man originally, but became one of our own and became an elected TD for the people of this constituency. It's a very proud Republican constituency. Monaghan's a very proud Republican county. We've had volunteers on the roll of honour such as Seamus McElwain, Jim Liner. It's the home adopted county of James Connolly. And today, I suppose, is an opportunity for us as Monaghan Republicans to showcase the strength and dynamism of Monaghan and Cavan Republicans. Indeed, there's been 8 months of work has gone into the preparation of this. You're going to see along the route pageantry, a lot of artistic displays. You're going to see the culmination of hundreds of people from County Monaghan, from County Cavan, and indeed surrounding counties who have come together to put on a very special spectacle to in honour of not only the 10 hunger strikers who died in 1981, but also the other 12 hunger strikers who died since 1917, starting with Thomas Dash. So this is a very proud day for all of us. Those people who have travelled are very welcome to County Monaghan. We hope they enjoy their visit, and we hope that people will leave here refreshed and inspired to continue in their work to deliver the objectives for which the 10 hunger strikers of 1981 gave their lives.
Well, it's wonderful to be in Monaghan, and very important that we, on the 32nd anniversary of the deaths of the hunger strikes in the Long Case, that we come to a place where the people clearly showed their support by electing Kieran Doherty as their TD in 1981. This is a day of dignified remembrance for Republicans from all over Ireland, and it's wonderful to be here to see such a huge turnout.
Yeah, well, you know, this is a constituency which elected Kieran Doherty, and I think all these decades later, it's brilliant to see such a huge crowd, and also to see the little historical enactments that are scattered along the route, and to see so many of the families here as well. So it's nice to remember the men who died in the AIDS blocks and the women who struggled in the prison in Armagh.
The support here today is overwhelming. 32 years have passed so quick, and every day I keep on hearing. But the thousands of people here today give the families great comfort, knowing that their loved ones, the sacrifice they give for Ireland, will never be forgotten. Every year the crowds increase. Kieran and his 9 comrades give their lives for Ireland and for the people of Ireland, and their sacrifice will never be forgotten. Their history is now with the Irish people, and they will be remembered forever. Kieran was elected here 32 years ago by the people of Cavan Monaghan. They've made a real bond with the Doherty family, and down to the years Kieran has been very close to us. Kieran supported his nomination, been put forward for the new political struggle, and that political struggle now embraces what Kieran did embrace in those days, being elected TD for Monaghan Cavan. And if we use the support of the hunger strikers today and their sacrifice and go forward, use the hunger strikers as an example and the young people today for the United Ireland that they wanted.
can see yourselves, it's an absolutely phenomenal turnout here this afternoon. It's a real tribute to the Monaghan organisation that this event's been put on. An enormous tribute to the organisation that elected Kieran Doherty 32 years ago here in Cavan and Monaghan. So it's a special time, I think, especially for the Doherty family and then for the organisation locally itself. Beautiful weather, there's a great vibe about the place, loads of bands, and perhaps best of all, we're hearing the revenge of our children and their laughter this afternoon because they're all out in their droves having a good time. I think it's a great day, great tribute to everybody. It's great to be here in Monaghan this afternoon.
Down here over the weekend, I was speaking last night at the Fergal O'Hanlon annual lecture. There was a great crowd of young people in particular there who are very interested in the political struggle that's going on and who have been inspired by our Patriot Day and particularly by the men who died in the hunger strike in 1981. Of course, I was there myself in 1981 on hunger strike and I replaced Kieran Doherty, who ironically was elected here as TD during the 1981 hunger strike. And as I was saying last night, it was a great honour at the time to replace Kieran on the hunger strike. But, you know, occasions like this are brilliant, particularly for young people, so that they can get a flavour of what happened in 1981. And I have no doubt, you know, that people hearing about the hunger strikers will be inspired by them and motivated by them to carry on the political struggle.
You are all very welcome to this special event, a special event for all Irish Republicans, but this very proud occasion for Cavan Monaghan Republicans in particular. You're welcome to this constituency that elected Belfast man Kieran Doherty as our TD. The home of Fergal O'Hanlon, Seamus McElwain, Jim Lynagh and many more. The parental home place of James Connolly. Those of us from here remain proud of their sacrifices and we are very humbled to remain part of their struggle. And we are also very proud and humbled to host this commemoration today. And we thank all of you, the thousands of you, who have made the effort to be here with us today. We are going to begin with something quite unique and very special. For the past number of months, under the auspices of an intergenerational project coordinated by Fáilte Cúnaimh, former POWs have been crafting a special sculpture, especially made for this weekend's commemoration. And I would now like to invite our dear friend, brother of Kieran Doherty, and a dedicated Republican in his own right, Michael Doherty, to unveil the sculpture that stands beside the stage. So I'll ask Michael to come to the stage. To ignite this sculpture into its full glory. and the flame of freedom is going to be symbolically passed from one generation of Ireland's freedom struggle to another. So, first, we have an actor representing, coming through the gates there, representing the pikemen of 1798 and the birth of Irish republicanism. Of freedom to an actor representing the volunteers of Easter Week 1916. The flame of freedom will now be carried to an actor representing the volunteers of Operation Harvest in 1956. Freedom is now passed on to a representation to the spirit of resistance to the British Army's re-entry into Irish streets in 1969. And the flame has now been passed to an actor representing those men we honour today, those who ensured that the flame still burns bright, the blanket men. Passed on to actors representing the most recent phase of our armed struggle. We're now going to ask a representative of each of the families of the 1981 hunger strikers to light a candle to represent those 10 men that died in 1981. Thank you, and once again to the families for their ongoing courage and commitment to our struggle. The struggle that each of those actors represent continues. Thanks to the previous generation, that struggle can now be carried out through peaceful means. That's not to say that it's easy. In order to achieve our objectives, we need to have what all other previous generations of Irish Republicans had: commitment, dedication, and honour. The flame will now pass on to somebody who has all those traits, somebody who will ignite this sculpture with the flame of freedom, and someone who in their own day-to-day work helps keep that flame of freedom alive. Somebody who will be a representative of this generation of Irish Republicans, the generation that will secure Irish unity. I now invite Senator Captain Riley to ignite this monument as a symbol of our determination to achieve the Republic.
honour of Irish Republican prisoners who died on hunger strike in the cause of Irish freedom. Thomas Ashe Carey, the 25th of September 1917. Michael Fitzgerald, Cork, 17th of October 1920. Terence McSweeney, Cork, the 25th of October 1920. Joseph Murphy, Cork, the 25th of October 1920. Joseph Whitty, Wexford, the 2nd of August 1923. Dennis Barry, Cork, the 20th of November 1923. Andy O'Sullivan, Cavan and Cork, the 22nd of November 1923. Tony Darcy, Galway, the 16th of April 1940. Jack Sean McNeela, Mayo, the 19th of April 1940. Sean McCaughey, Tyrone, the 11th of May 1946. Michael Gaughan, Mayo, the 3rd of June 1974. Frank Stagg, Mayo, the 12th of February 1976. Bobby Sands, Belfast, an MP from Amasar, Tyrone, the 5th of May 1981. Francie Hughes, Derry, the 12th of May 1981. Raymond McCreesh, South Armagh, the 21st of May 1981. Patsy O'Hara, Derry, the 21st of May 1981. Joe MacDonald, Belfast, the 8th of July 1981. Martin Herson, Tyrone, the 13th of July 1981. Kevin Lynch, Derry, the 1st of August 1981. Kieran Doherty, Belfast, TD, Cavan, Monaghan, on the 2nd of August, 1981. Tom McElwee, Derry, on the 8th of August, 1981. Michael Devine, Derry, the 20th of August, 1981. Fuair Siad Bás, her son, Saoirse na hÉireann.
Well, I have to say I'm absolutely delighted with the turnout here today, and we always knew that the content was going to be a wow factor for people coming here. We have planned this over the past 9 and 10 months, and I want to pay tribute to the organising committee. We have a great team here in County Monaghan, and with help from our friends in County Cavan, we knew that we would put on a very special commemoration in honour of not only the hunger strikers of our time, Frank Stagg and Michael Gaughan, and the 10 who died in 1981, but linking together and commemorating the memory of all 22 hunger strikers who died from Thomas Ashe in 1917 right up to this time. It's very important to remember that this is one struggle. There are many phases, but it is one struggle. The self-same heartbeat was in Thomas Ashe as was in Mickey Devine at the very end of the 22 who have died. We hope there will never be another name to be added to that list, and the only way that we can achieve that is by staying solidly on the path towards the realisation of our Republican goals, and our strategy is that path. We have confidence in it, and today there are young Sinn Féin activists, the length and breadth of this island, not only willing but capable and able of bringing this struggle forward to its conclusion, a successful conclusion, when one day we will gather in crowds just such as this throughout the length and breadth of this island in celebration of the realisation of the Republic declared in Easter week 1916. I think it's also very important to bear in mind that the death of Kieran Doherty in 1981 inspired a whole new generation of young people, many of them who came from families with no traditional Republican allegiance. They're self-taught, they have developed their politics and their activism
and on the greater number of those we have built to a point that in 2013 and since 2004, Sinn Féin is the largest party in this county. We are part of the legacy of the martyrs of 1981, and we want to see what we have achieved in this county replicated throughout the island of Ireland. It is very, very important in speaking to activists today who come from 1981 that was their genesis in terms of their politics and activism, that for them in their lifetime what happened in 1981 was absolutely life-changing. It was their 1916 in this time, and I think it's also very gratifying to see before us here today another generation of young people for whom 1981 is a new story. They're only been introduced to everything that we lived through. So it is very, very important to keep handing on the message, and as the symbolism of today's event showed, handing on the torch of freedom, because we can't go on forever. We need a new generation of young people to be standing there willing to fill our places, and I have every confidence that here in Monaghan we will do that, and I want to encourage people the length and breadth of Ireland to replicate that approach. I'd also like to remind people that the very first hunger strikers were women. They were suffragettes fighting for the right of women to have a vote. In 1912 they were on hunger strike in Mountjoy Prison. In 1915, James Connolly and Hannah Sheehy Skeffington, they were on hunger strike at the time of the period after the Great Lockout of 1913. The continued campaigning that is very little known of. I didn't know before the research for this event that James Connolly himself had been on hunger strike. So going through our history it's a pathway in education. It's a learning process, but it must also be an inspiration and an encouragement to a new generation to write the next chapter.
Event organised in commemoration of the hunger strikers, and indeed those hunger strikers not just from 1981 but right down through the 20th century in Irish history. For me as a young Republican, indeed as a young Republican from the Cavan Monaghan constituency, which did elect Ciarán Doherty TD, it is an absolute honour and a privilege to be here. I think when we look, for example, at the pageantry that was on display here, looking at Irish Republicanism right down through history, it really gave us a sense of what it means to be an Irish Republican today. And the theme was Irish Republicanism, as I said, down through history, but looking forward to the future, that we all have the fire of freedom within us. And it was a privilege for myself to light the flame of freedom, to reignite that, and looking at commemorating all our hunger strikers. As I said, being from the constituency that elected Ciarán Doherty TD, and looking forward to the electoral gains of Sinn Féin and for Irish Republicanism into the future, I think there is a lot of work there to do, but I think coming forward from today's event, it has reinforced our sense of republicanism to build a new republic going forward. And I look forward to working with all our thousands of comrades that are here today from right across the 32 counties to do that.